Hello, I'm Bruce Garber, the producer of Go the Distance TV, which highlights people that have gone the distance in their lives by inspiring or motivating others. I had the opportunity to do some traveling and decided to bring a camera along with me. The show was called Go the Distance TV, and we sure did. We went halfway around the world to Japan, recorded some of my experiences, and captured a few special moments in the process. In this episode from Japan, I will share with you some of the culture and interesting places I visited. On upcoming shows, I will highlight some interesting and inspirational people that I have met along the way. I hope you enjoy the show.
We're here visiting this castle. It's supposed to be a very famous place. I don't have a lot of detail on it quite yet, but hopefully during this tour we'll be able to understand a little bit more. I have my friend Sato-san here again with us, and his wife Makiko-san will be joining us today as well. They both speak pretty decent English, and hopefully we'll be able to help translate some of what we're going to be seeing. So let's go inside and check out this castle. Hello everybody once again. Right now we're inside the castle. Unfortunately, there is no picture taken, there is no video allowed inside the castle. But I'd like to introduce you to my good friend Makiko-san, who is actually standing just outside these doors, and she'll be able to talk to us hopefully and tell us why the castle is famous, and we'll be able to see the surrounding area from on top. So let me introduce you to Makiko-san. This is my friend Makiko.
Mm-hmm. Hi.
And, hi, how are you?
Hi.
And what we would like to do is just maybe we will take the camera outside.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Is that okay? Well, let's go outside with Makiko. So Makiko.
Yes.
Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Can you tell us a little bit about this castle, the name of it, and what makes it famous?
Yes, this castle's name is Kaminoyama, Kaminoyama Castle. So the king of the Kaminoyama Castle was so famous. He worked for the people. It was about 300 years ago. And the king of the Kaminoyama Castle keeping around this area to keep the peace for a long time. So he is so famous around here.
And can you tell us a little bit about what we're seeing outside?
Yeah.
On these mountains and the name of the town that the castle is
Yes.
in?
So the mountains, there are many highest mountains. This is so famous ski area in Japan. The mountain name is Zao. So Zao is very good skiing area.
Okay.
Yeah. And along the mountain, there are many hot springs.
Oh, hot springs.
Yes. So many traveler visitor is coming around here to see the hot spring. Many Japan loves hot spring.
Now, hot spring, can you explain a little bit about what hot spring is? Is it like a resort area for resting?
Yes.
And
like a resort.
Okay.
So this castle's name is Kaminoyama, and the city name is Kaminoyama City.
It's very windy day. Especially on top of the castle. Yonezawa is surrounded by mountains.
Yeah.
So Makiko, can you tell me a little bit what this guy is doing way down there?
Yeah, actually that is a hot spring. they are warming their legs for in the hot spring. Lusa, so we can go there. Can you talk?
Oh, maybe.
Can you tell me what you're making me do?
Okay.
Tell me what this is.
Yes. So Blue-san is trying to enter the little hot spring to warm his legs. Hot spring is very popular in Japan. And this area hot spring is very good.
Here we go, guys.
Yeah. Hey, Bruce, how do you feel?
It's hot.
Too hot?
Very hot.
Very hot. Relax.
This is like the whirlpool without the motor.
Oh.
Very after you get used to it, it's very relaxed. This is my friend Mexico before. She's helping me dry my feet.
Yeah.
Well, that was very enjoyable. I'm sure there'll be some more interesting things that we get to try during our trip here in Japan. My trip got extended approximately another week. So, I have this weekend where Sato-san and Kiko-san is showing me some of the local area. Also tonight, there's a snow festival, Yonezawa Snow Festival, very famous. And we hope to go and see some of that. Now it's been warm here, as I understand it's been back at home. So a lot of snow has been melting. So from what I understand is that they're shipping snow in from the mountain for the snow festival this evening. It's a 2-day event, Saturday and Sunday, where they actually make some snow sculptures. They have some food and things like that. So hopefully later on tonight we'll be able to show you some of that. Anyway, for now, from Hutch Springs in front of the castle, we'll see you again soon.
Festival. Nice to meet you. My name is Mari Ishikawa. So today and tomorrow, Yonezawa Festival, very calm, many people. So I hope and Bruce too. So next time, see you. 本日は Yonezawa へお越しいただきまして誠にありがとうございます。2月14日15日と米沢上杉祭り雪道路祭りがありまして 今日は一緒にブルースと来ております。とても楽しんでおりますので皆さんぜひ来てください。じゃあバイバイ。はい。こちらはジャパニーズセイトーローです。 I can't understand in English. Sorry.
That's funny. You telling Japanese joke? Samurai sculpture.
So Japanese say, Japanese mean I. English say love, love. Look around, a very beautiful red, yellow, blue. I like it. How about you?
Very pretty. And kimchi.
Kimchi. This is a Japanese takoyaki.
What is it?
Made of like a pound cake.
Pound cake?
すいません、一つください。
お持ち帰りで。
はい。はい。
はい、どうもありがとうございます。
あ、そう。Do you like a chicken?
Yeah.
Do you like chicken?
Yes. Yonezawa beef.
Yes.
Very famous.
はい、いらっしゃいいらっしゃいよ。あったつくしゃじゃよ、おいしいよし、くしゃんだ。はい、いらっしゃいいらっしゃいいらっしゃいいらっしゃい。
Octopus. How do you say in Japanese?
Takoyaki.
Say again?
Takoyaki.
Takoyaki. Octopus. Wow. I don't think for me. I don't think so.
Thank you.
did.
You're very good.
So tell me what it is.
This is amazake.
Amazake.
Sweet Japanese sake.
Sweet Japanese sake?
Very polite. Oh,
thank you. Domo.
Thank
you. Domo.
It's free.
Good.
Very good. Getting very hot.
Really?
Good morning. We're here again the following morning. It's the morning after the first night of the Yonezawa Snow Festival. And it's not quite as busy this morning as it was last night. So hope you enjoy some of the sights and sounds. Walking around, it's quite unusual and funny in a way. Last night I was very fortunate to have a friend with me that took me around and helped me do what I want. We're about 250 miles northwest of Tokyo, and here in Yonezawa, very little English is spoken. It's a very old part of the country. It's this place where the snow festival takes place is actually an old samurai village, and it's where the samurai came to train. I hope you enjoyed some of the sights and sounds of Japan, and we look forward to seeing you back home soon. Domo arigato gozaimasu. Thanks for watching. See you soon.
I hope you enjoyed this episode of Go the Distance TV all the way from Japan. If you'd like to see more, log on to GoTheDistanceTV.com, where you can watch past shows and sign the guest book. I hope some of the sights, sounds, and people have motivated and inspired you to go the distance in your life. Until next time, go the distance.